ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नारं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। नाष्टभयेष्वदेशो नित्यं भगवद्सेवया भगवद्योत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिके।
So we are reading from the Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto, 2nd chapter, text number 35. Evam vilapatinam vai parigriyam mritam patim anichatinam nirharam arko astam sanyavartata evam vilapatinam vai parigriyamritam patim anichatinam nirharam arkostam sanyavartata evam vilapatinam vai parigriyamritam patim anichati nam nirharam arkostam sanyavartata evam vilapati nam vai parigriyam ritam patim anichati nam nirharam arkastam sanyavartata evam das vilapati nam of the lamenting queens why indeed parigriya, taking on their laps, mritam, the dead, patim, husband, anichatinam, not desiring, nirharam, the carrying out of the body, for the funeral ceremony, arka, the sun, astam, the setting position, sanyavartata, passed away. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki. Translation. The time was appropriate for the body to be burnt, but the queens, not allowing it to be taken away, continued lamenting for the dead body, which they kept on their laps. In the meantime, the sun, completed its movements for setting in the west. Purport. According to the Vedic system, if a person dies during the daytime, it is customary for his funeral ceremony to be performed before the sun sets, regardless of whether he is burned or buried. And if he dies at night, the funeral must be completed before the next sunrise. Apparently, the queens continued lamenting for the dead body, the lump of matter, and would not allow it to be taken away for burning. This illustrates the strong grip of illusion among foolish persons who consider the body the self. Women are generally considered less intelligent. Because of ignorance only, the queens thought of the dead body as their husband, and somehow or other thought that if the body were kept, the husband would remain with them. Such a conception of the self is certainly for gokara, cows and asses. We've actually seen that sometimes when a cow's calf has died, the milkman cheats the cow by presenting before her the dead body of her calf. Thus the cow, who would not otherwise allow milking, licks the dead body of the calf and allows herself to be milked. This substantiates the description of the Shastra that a foolish man in the bodily concept of life is like a cow. Not only do foolish men and women consider the body the self, but we have even seen that the dead body of a so-called yogi was kept for days by his disciples who thought that their guru was in samadhi. Sisi Goni Tai Krishnam Sisi Radha Shama Sundarki. When decomposition began and a bad smell unfortunately began to overwhelm the yogic power, the disciples allowed the dead body of the so-called yogi to be burned. Thus, the bodily concept of life is extremely strong among foolish persons who are compared to cows and asses. Nowadays, great scientists are trying to freeze dead bodies so that in the future these frozen bodies may again be brought to life. The incident narrated by Hiranyakashipu from history must have taken place millions of years ago, because Hiranyakashipu lived millions of years ago and was even then quoting from history. Thus, the incident occurred before Hiranyakashipu's lifetime. But the same ignorance in the bodily concept of life is still prevalent, not only among laymen, but even among scientists who think they will be able to revive frozen corpses. Apparently, the queens did not want to deliver the dead body for burning because they were afraid of dying with the dead body of their husband. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshurun Miritam Minam Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhistam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Sayam Rupakadamayam Dadati Sabadantikam Bandeham Sri Guru Sri Yutapadakamalan Sri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sagana Raganathanvitam Tam Sajivam
Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sagana Lalita Sri Vishakanvitam Sha. He Krishna Kuruna Sindhu Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hare Priye Panchakalpaturubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhyeva Cha Paritanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Adaita Gadadhara Shivajari Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Evam Vilapati Nam Vai Parigriyam Ritam Patim Anichati Nam Nirharam Arkustam Sanyavartata. The time was appropriate for the body to be burnt, but the queens, not allowing it to be taken away, continued lamenting for the dead body, which they kept on their laps. In the meantime, the sun completed its movement for setting in the west. So Hiranyakashipu speaking to his relatives and here actually relating one incident from bygone ages to appease the relatives. And so we can see, and that it is mentioned, that he had some knowledge of the Vedic literatures, but at the same time some misconception was there. And not understanding, by the Lord's will also, that Vishnu is the Supreme Lord, and he even wanted to kill Vishnu, which is not possible. And we can see, as explained here, that this is very prevalent, this misconception, this bodily conception of life, identifying with this material body. And due to that not understanding properly what is the absolute truth, what is the purpose of life, how to understand the absolute truth, and realizing even the self, the Atma, beyond the material body, beyond the gross and subtle body. So basically in the material world, we can say that almost everyone is an illusion. But then the Supreme Lord himself is coming, trying to deliver the fallen conditioned souls, establishing dharma, the principles of religion. Or he sends his representatives who on behalf of the Supreme Lord are trying to deliver the fallen conditioned souls from their misconceptions. So by nature, as we know, everyone is eternal servant of Krishna. Everyone has a Satchidananda Sarup. Everyone is eternal, full of bliss and knowledge. By nature. Jivera Svaupoi Krishnera Nittadas. But due to coming in this material world, so this original consciousness is covered. And then the living entity is identifying with his material body, with the things surrounding him. So identifying with the gross body or with the subtle body. But the purpose then, of course, of these revealed scriptures, the Srimad Bhagavatam, is to revive the dormant Krishna consciousness of the living entity, of every living entity. So by the Lord's will also, and
So this material world is manifested, it is, as it is explained even by Srila Prabhupada in one purport and in the scriptures, even the material world, the manifestation of the material world, that is Krishna's pastime. Yes, his eternal pastime is going on in the spiritual world, but then he's manifesting sometimes this material world. And then some jivas, they come to this material world. So the conditioned souls who since time immemorial, they've been conditioned. Nitya bada, anadikal bada, since time immemorial. But by nature, they are also eternal servants of Krishna. So to revive, to arouse the dormant Krishna consciousness, so these living entities are just like sleeping, not knowing what is happening. And to awaken them to spiritual consciousness, to their relationship with Krishna, so the Bhagavatam is revealed, the Supreme Lord is coming, and the representative of the pure the Lord, the pure devotees, so they are coming. So the instructions given by Hiranyakashipu are to some extent appropriate, but just the misconception was there that and that Vishnu is not the Supreme Lord, and he can, and we want to even kill him. So here in this verse, Ivam Vilapati Nam. So the queens, they were lamenting, which is actually quite natural. So these emotions are there. So when the dear one is leaving this world, it is natural that those are related to that person, they will cry. Whereas love, then there will be, when the dear one is disappearing or is even going somewhere, then the separation is there. And then vilap is there, lamentation is there. And we should understand that actually all emotions are there in the spiritual realm. And because they are there in the spiritual realm, they also hear. But because Krishna is not in the center, so these emotions are not pure. They are material. These different emotions, they cannot be stopped. And therefore we can see that even amongst the devotees, if sometimes, let's say in a grihastha ashram, one of the members leaves the body, then naturally the other relatives, they may cry, vilap, they may lament. That is quite natural when there's a loving relationship there. And especially, as we know, so the jivatmas in a male body, they are more able to control, and maybe even sometimes they are more hard-hearted. Whereas the jivas in the female body, they are more soft and more emotional, and they can very easily cry, more easily. So especially if the husband is leaving, and let's say the wife is not yet so old, like even in this case, so they were still expecting him to live longer, but he lost in the battle and he was killed. So naturally they were depending on him and they wanted to enjoy life, and so he's not there, then, and they were naturally lamenting. So that cannot be avoided, the different feelings are there, it is natural. But Krishna has to be in the center, and we have to be properly situated, trying to be on the transcendental platform beyond the gross and subtle body, Atma, Tattva, platform of the soul. And there also, this lamentation is there. Even actually, in order to attain perfection in life, we have to actually cry out in separation from Krishna, or even first in separation from Mahaprabhu, or even we may see in separation from the spiritual master. Just like when Prabhupada left his body here in Srivindavan Dham, 1977. So the devotees knew Prabhupada is not this body. He's an eternal servant of Mahaprabhu and Krishna. We are not this body. But when he left this world, everyone who was there was crying. Even they heard all over the world. They heard the news and they knew he will leave. So many devotees were crying, vilap, lamenting. Prabhupada left. So he left the body, but still we know that everyone is eternal. So, and he's still there, Srila Prabhupada, so we worship him every day. And so in his vani is there, his instructions are there. And so beyond even this level of physical level, which we can easily perceive, like the Acharya Sarup of Srila Prabhupada, so that is now in Samadhi here. We have the Samadhi, his body is there. But his instructions are there. And not only that, but we know and we understand that is there in Gaur Leela and also in Krishna Leela, serving Mahaprabhu constantly in the Nitya Leela and serving Sisi Radha Krishna in the Nitya Leela. And at the same time, he may also be in one of the other universes preaching Krishna consciousness by the will of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So everyone is eternal. And so definitely, as Krishna therefore says in the Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna, you should not lament. Why are you lamenting for the body? There is no need. And then gave him the first instruction. Most important, we should understand we are not this body. We are spirit soul. But these different emotions are there, which are natural, and there is no need to suppress also. Viraha bhava is there, vipralamba bhava is there, as shown also especially by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who has come to this world, who is a Yuga Avatar, established the Yuga Dharma, the chanting of the holy names, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So he was there in Jagannath Puri after having taken sannyas. So first his wonderful pastimes are there in Navadvip, and Mayapur Navadvip, and then, as we know, he entered into the sannyas ashram. And then, as we know, he had a young wife. He was just going to be 25 years old on his holy appearance day, which we are going to celebrate in just a few weeks, Gaur Purnima. So just it was actually in Magh Mas. So different, some say Pratipatiti, some say Tritiatiti. Some even say Purnima Titi of the Magh Mas, but whatever, in Magh Mas, Makra Sankranti, mid-January, so he entered into the sannyas ashram. His wife might be just 16 years old. And his mother, Sachimata, she already lost her husband. And before that, even before Nimai Pandit appeared, so she gave birth to some children, but they all left the body. So if a mother is there giving birth to a child and the child is dying very soon after that, what she will do? She will cry. So Sachimata, she was crying every year, one of her child left. And then, by the will of the Lord, and she's a pure devotee of Mahaprabhu and Krishna. She's actually, as we know, Yashoda Maa and Krishna Leela. And Mahaprabhu is no different from Radha and Krishna. So then after that, as we know, so by the will of the Lord, one more child appeared who was a non-different or expanded form of Balaram, Vishwarup. And he grew up very nicely, and then Nimai appeared and she was happy. But then what happened, he was just in the bath of his youth, and naturally Satchimatan wanted to get him married. So Jagannath Mishra had left, and also, and then Vishwarup, he took sannyas, he left. Then only Nimai Pandit was there. Nimai! So that's all she had after that. So he grew up, and so she was taking care of him, and then she got him married and to Lakshmi Priya. And then when he went for preaching, so Lakshmi Priya, feeling separation, she was bit by the snake of separation. So she was feeling separation, her Prabhu, her Swami, Nimai Pandit, went for preaching. So she was feeling so much separation, lamenting, crying also. Although he was coming back, but she left. And of course, Satchimata again, she was unhappy, her daughter-in-law was consoling her when Mahaprabhu was going to preach, when Nimai Pandit was going to preach. She left also. And then after, so she felt well. Nimai, of course, when he came back, and so Nimai, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Visayasarayashvarya Purna Bhagavan, Swayam Bhagavan knows everything. But he didn't say anything. And then she had to give the sad news to Nimai Pandit. And externally speaking, also he was showing some signs of lamentation. Oh, my dear wife, Lakshmi Priya left. And after some time, Satchimata thought he should get married again. He should not take sannyas. Even one time she had asked him, she had begged him, please, you should not leave, you should not take sannyas. And Mahaprabhu pacified her, don't worry, don't worry. And so by the will of the Lord, then again he was engaged and got married with Vishnu Priya, his eternal consort. And for a little while they lived together happily, and Satchimata was very happy. And then he started the Sankirtan movement, as we know, performing his wonderful pastimes. Dvija Shiromani, the crest jewel amongst all the Dvijas, the twice-born Brahmanas, so exemplary. Of course, as a child he was very naughty, just like Krishna. But then he was a good student, he was excellent, and then he was teaching also, as was the custom. The elder boys, they have learned and they teach and they learn more. So he was very exemplary, just to teach us, to show us, according to Vana Ashram also, how to act in the different situations. Then the Sankirtan movement was started, the chanting of the holy names, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And so he showed us also in which mood to chant, bhav, not that you just chant mechanically and nothing is there in the brain, in the consciousness, or just thinking about material things, what I'm going to eat at noontime, or this problem, that problem. No. Krishna, Krishna, nama, non-different. So we have to endeavor also and pray and cry. So we can see Sri Guru Gauranga and Krishna while chanting and nothing material. So Mahaprabhu, his example, he showed, and that He was absorbed then in the mood of, of course, of a devotee and praying. He's the Supreme Lord, but he came to show us how to serve, how to worship Krishna. And then one time he was chanting, Gopi, Gopi, remembering the gopis, praying to the gopis. And then some brahmanas, they were saying, why are you chanting Gopi, Gopi? You should chant Krishna's name. But they didn't understand his mood. And of course there were some discussions were there, and then he chased them away because they disturbed his mood. And then he wanted to retaliate and beat him up, which is not possible. He has all strength. He's most powerful. But then he felt, I should enter the sannyas ashram. So then everyone will respect me. Because in India, in Bharatvarsha, everyone will respect the sannyasis. Because they know the sannyasis are absorbed in worshipping the Lord. They are engaged fully with body, mind, and words and spiritual activities. So they are respected. They are to be respected. And so to deliver Patita Pavana Hetu Tavavatar, to deliver the fallen conditioned souls of the age of Kali. So then he took sannyas. And then as we know, when he decided, so he had met by his own sweet will, by the will of Providence externally, Keshava Bharati had come to Mayapur Navadvip and he asked him, can you please award me sannyas? He said, yes, no problem. So then at a certain time, so he felt now it is the time to go. So that time he went to his dear devotee also, Sridhar, and begged for some sabji, loki, vegetable. And then he asked his mother to make loki halva. So shredding the vegetable and then putting in the milk and sugar and maybe little ghee at the end, and it becomes very tasty. And he offered to his deity, Shaligram Shila, known as Padmanab. The name of his Shila was Padmanab. He offered, and then he had some chanting of the holy names. And so then that same night, then he left. And when he left, so first he was speaking also to his dear wife, Vishnupriya, very sweetly, very nicely. And that morning, actually, when she was taking bath, so actually her nose ring fell into the Ganges River. So the married ladies, they have some things they are always wearing. One is a nose ring, one is a Mangal Sutra. And then some bangles, they have a bindi and sindur, so that others can recognize, oh, that is a married woman. So she lost that, and she was very much worried. She had told Satchimata, and she said, all these things are happening. We will get other one. Don't worry. So the night time, so it was time to take rest, and Nimai Pandit was speaking very nicely to her, very lovingly. And more than usual, she was surprised, why today he's spending so much time with me? Usually he's not spending so much time. So, and then, by his influence, she fell asleep. And then Satchimata also had some idea she had heard, and she was standing at the doorway. She became like stunned. She could not move. And Nimai Pandit circumambulated her, offered pranam with folded hands and left. And she couldn't say anything. He didn't say anything. He crossed the river Ganges and went to Katwa. And the next morning, the ceremony was performed in Katwa. And the devotees, they heard about that. And they were all crying. And in Katwa, so the barber was asked to cut the hair, but so beautiful, Nimai Pandit, young, not even 25 years. Everybody there, hi, hi. Such a beautiful personality, beautiful hair, young person, going to take sannyas. And everyone was crying, even the barber was crying. So we see this lamentation is there, but Krishna has to be in the center, Mahaprabhu has to be in the center. And then by this crying, then actually we become closer to Krishna. Our consciousness is purified. And then Krishna may manifest in our heart. And then still, even that time, even when we have purified consciousness, we may see Krishna in our heart. Sometimes when Krishna is disappearing, crying, then we are crying. Or even the eternal associates, Srimati Radharani. And when Krishna goes for the pasturing pastime, pasturing grounds, taking out the cows and the calves, then she's feeling separation, many times crying, Mother Yashoda also. So crying is actually very helpful, but Krishna has to be in the center. So the devotees, they're very fortunate by the mercy of Mahaprabhu, mercy of Prabhupada. So we have this transcendental knowledge by which we can become free from this material lamentation, material concept of life, material crying. So Mahaprabhu by his own example. So he's showing this Vipralamba Bhav, and that is actually important to. And Prabhupada used to say we should chant Hare Krishna and cry. And then he was saying, if we cannot cry, we should cry. When will the day come that I can cry? And Mahaprabhu said, Nayanam Gadadashudaraya Varanam Gad Gadaruriya Gada Pulaka Nichiram Vapagda Tavanam Agrahani Bhavishyati. When will the tears come from my eyes like torrents of rain while chanting the holy names? So here we can see the queens, they were crying because her husband left. Bodily concept of life. So even sometimes devotees are crying, Gurudev has left, which is very nice. That is natural. Or the dear one left, crying is good. But then also, actually, even when no dear one, or even the guru is here, or he had left, so we cried one time. So now we should still sometimes see that we can actually cry in separation from Krishna, in separation of Mahaprabhu. So that is very healthy. So, and then we can be, so then we are properly situated, and then even so then we can see the things properly as they are, and then we can help others also. So we are very fortunate, we are here in Srimindavan Dham, have taken shelter of Srila Prabhupada. So now it is our duty to try to give this Krishna consciousness to others, and to help others who are in ignorance. And that same thing many times, most of the devotees, not only in the West, but even in India, the family members are not devotees. So then we have to be properly situated, and then well equipped with transcendental knowledge, and then we may use these different examples from the scriptures to teach them, to try to bring them to Krishna consciousness. So that is now, that is our duty. Otherwise, as Prabhupada is explaining here, Gokara, and that Krishna himself, who is the supreme teacher, Adiguru, in his wonderful pastimes, when he was present, he gave some instructions, first of all to Arjuna, as we know, but then to other personalities also, to Uddhav in the 11th canto, practically almost the whole 11th canto is Krishna speaking to Uddhav, giving so many wonderful instructions for our benefit about Vana Ashram, the different Vanas, different Ashrams, even about deity worship. So he also spoke to the yes, to the gopis in a sometimes joking way in Braj, or when they met in Kurukshetra. At that time he spoke to the gopis also. And there the famous verse is there. Yasmat yasatma buddhi kunape tridatuke sadi kaladadri shubhauma ijjadi yatirta buddhi shalile nakar hichit janesh abhigyeshu sa eva go karaha. As Prabhupada is explaining here. Gokara, cow and asses. So if one is simply in the bodily concept of life, so then one is not better than the cow or the asses. So that is mentioned that he was explaining Krishna to the gopis, one who identifies itself as the body composed of three dhatu, mucus, bile and air, who assumes his wife and family are permanently his own, who thinks an earthen image or the land of his birth is worshipable, or who sees a place of pilgrimage as merely the water there, but who never identifies himself with the self, with the Atma. So one who is not going to the holy places to inquire about the absolute truth by approaching a spiritual master, a saintly person, such a person is no better than a cow or an ass. Of course, of the two, the cow is better than the ass. So we should be situated in goodness, and we should have always tried to serve others and help others and be just like the cow, who is a very wonderful animal and producing milk, which is very important. So we should, by our activities, so we should produce something very nice and for the benefit of the Supreme Lord, and then we should try to help the fallen conditioned souls to become free from this bodily concept of life. But first of all, we have to take care of our own selves and try to ourselves be properly situated on the transcendental platform. Not just theoretically, I am not this body, I am servant of Krishna. That is jnana, that is knowledge, that is the first step. But then we should realize, practically speaking, that we are not this body. And we should realize our real relationship with Krishna. That is the goal of life. And that is real self-realization, atma-sakshakar. By practically realizing ourselves, not just theoretically, in our relationship with Krishna. Hare Krishna, Om Tat Sat. Any comments, Maharaj or Panchagoda Prabhu? Any comments? Or any questions? There's some, Prabhuji has a question. So it's already 9:05, so one question and...
You said you must align that we are our body.
Yes.
The soul. What is the quickest way to
align
that we are servant of Krishna?
What is the quickest way?
Yes.
By chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. That is the quickest way by practically realizing. And basically there is no other way. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Eva Kevalam. But at the same time, you have to be in the association of the advanced devotees who will guide you so you can properly chant Hare Krishna. And you should worship the deities and you should every day hear the Bhagavatam and read the scriptures. Then you can chant properly also, otherwise you cannot chant properly. And then you cannot advance rapidly. So it is a process by which you can quickly realize. But the main activity is chanting the holy names. But then you must associate with the sadhus, you must worship the deities, you must daily study the scriptures. Then you can chant nicely the Maha Mantra with a proper consciousness. Then you can remember the Lord while chanting the holy names. And then you can quickly realize Krishna Swarup and your own Swarup. Okay, practically speaking. Of course, quickly, that may take more than just a few days or a few years. depending on the intensity of our endeavor and depending also on the environment and the purva samskara, the previous impressions. So many factors are there. But ultimately we don't have to worry because we are on the right path, and very quickly we will achieve perfection, no doubt. You just have to take this verse around your neck. Trinarapi sunichena tarorapi sahishnuna amanina marinena kirtaniya sarahari. Hare Krishna.